Right, you want to turn all your equipment on to start. And then you're going to open up your program here and you sign in. Usually your password will be saved and you want to connect to us, you sign in. So what you're going to be doing is going to new order, but before you do that, you want to get this elevating plate. See that it has the notch. The notch goes right here. You want to make sure they line up. It should snap on like that. And what we're going to do first, we are going to do some calibrating of the device because we did move it. So anytime you move your scanner, you want to make sure that everything is calibrated. First, you want to take off this plastic plate without touching this surface because the light reflects off of that. And it's very important you do not touch that. Again, this has a little notch. You line it up like so. Then when you go to your screen, you'll see that there is this little like bullseye up here. It says plus 4 days. So that means it's been 4 days since the last calibration. And 4 days ago, we did move the scanner. So we have to recalibrate. So you click on that, left click. You'll see that there's two different calibrations. You have the white balance calibration. We'll do that after we calibrate with the light. And you just push start. And this part of the calibration takes a little longer than the white balance one. The white balance will be very short and sweet. I'm gonna fast forward through this part. Okay, the calibration is successful. So you'll X out of the box. We did one part of the calibration. We have to go back and do the white balance calibration. So before we do that, you have to put this plate on the calibration device. You hear a little snap like that, and you're good to go. So then you'll just click on this here and start this. And this is important too because it captures all the light throughout the room and it makes sure that the scan is very accurate. And like I said, this is very quick and seamless. So we are done calibrating the device. So you want to remove this off the table and keep this lifter up there. Put it back in your felt bag, which comes in this box, so that we do not damage it. And make sure that this is tucked away nicely in your box. So we're done with that until we move the scanner. All right, so we're gonna type in patient Smith. And if we're gonna be fabricating the dentures, we're good to go to start with the order. But if you are just scanning it so we can keep these on file, study or scan only, you wanna type in after. So that way we do not fabricate anything for this patient's case. So I'm gonna keep it as scan only, so we'll keep this on record and not fabricate anything. So next you will select just any tooth and you'll see that this menu comes up. You'll go down to full denture, click on full denture. Make sure this box right here, you unclick the scan bite rim. Otherwise you can misalign your scans up. And you go to finish. You'll see this occlusion type drop-down menu here. You want to go to no occlusal type, and then you're ready to scan. Click that. You'll see that basically this will walk you through the pictures. It's like a little roadmap here, but you go to lower jaw. So we're going to be doing the lower denture. You want to grab this base plate. You'll see this notch here. You want to get your blue tack. I like to make like a little square, little cube. That way it keeps the denture off of the plate. You'll see why I do that, so we can cut it out later in the scan. So you want to fix that on the plate like so. Try to keep that as parallel as possible, and you'll see why later. You want to grab this Scantist vanishing spray. And this will disappear on its own. What this is doing is getting rid of the glare so the scanner can pick everything up, all the data. Again, you want to line the notch up with this notch, like so. And we are good to go. You can see in this window here, this is what the scan is looking at. So you'll push the play button and it'll start the scan. So we're doing occlusal surface first, and you can see here that the denture itself is being cut out. So I'm gonna drop this down just a little bit. And you can see now that's why we have the blue tack up so high, so I can cut this little plate out of the scan. So you want to take a look at it, make sure you have all the data. It looks pretty good. There's one little area there that, you know, it's not 100% important that we capture that, but just to show you what we can do to add a little more data to the scan, you hit the A, you'll highlight a little area, and then you'll push the play button, and it'll rescan that area to get that data. You can see it's highlighting that area, and that's gone. So the clear spot is gone because it actually captured all the data. So I'm happy with the scan, so I'm ready to move on to the intaglio surface. And to do so, you go to this little M here in this little window, and you flip it, and we're going to do the intaglio surface. And you can see here that it's saying to flip the model or denture. So you go to your plate, you can do it on it, or I like to remove it. Bring this up a little bit more with the blue tack. Doing the antagonist surface now. Make sure that it's nice and stable. You're going to use your Scantus spray. Again, with the notch to the notch. There we are. And once you have that on there, you can see this is what the scanner is looking at. You push play. All right, so now we have a good scan here. You can see the plate. The reason why I put the blue tack up so high is so that way we don't have to cut the plate out too much. You want to, when it's, the circle is blue, you can go up and down. Like if that plate is green, you want to make sure it's maroon. That way it's cut out of the scan. You can see that we're looking pretty good there. I might raise it up just a smidge. Make sure we have all the data, not cutting anything else out. You can tilt the plate like that if you need to. Just looking at it, looks like we're good to go. So then, push the check mark, you're gonna confirm, you like all the data that we got, you can see everything's in there. Go to finish. See now the lower has a check mark, the lower has been scanned. So now we're moving to the upper jaw, which is the upper denture. So remove the plate, remove the lower denture, set it aside, get your blue tack. I like to make that little cube again so that way we can keep the denture off the plate. And everyone has their own little processes, but I think this works out very well so that way you can cut out the plate as needed. Occlusal side first. Sometimes the powder makes it not stick. And I believe you guys will be using rubber dams over this plate, so that way you don't have to worry about sanitizing or autoclaving this plate. I'm gonna use the spray. Good to start the scan. See the upper scan is done. Just take a look at it, see if there's any missing data. Just me being a little OCD, I'm gonna highlight that area, hit the A again. Let's see that and that. Play. It's going to capture the missing data. see it extended that little flange there a little bit more. So you want to make sure you capture all the data. As it's scanning, you can take a look at the rest of the appliance. Okay, the occlusal surface is done. Okay, you can see the scan's done. We did a little bit of touch up. So we're good there. So now we're going to flip it and do the intaglio surface. So you take the plate off if you like. I always like to because it's more stable on the table. Use your blue tack again. Make sure it's somewhat parallel. It's easy to cut this plate out after it's scanned. Spray your powder, so it captures everything, gets rid of all the glare. Again, put the notch to the notch. And then once you have that on the plate, push play or scan. Once the scan is done, you'll see that this little plate here from that, the scan looks good. You want to left click on your mouse or the mouse pad and make sure that this plate is maroon. It'll cut that out of the scan, the information that you send to us. Just do a quick look, make sure that nothing else is being cut out while you're raising this, because sometimes you can cut out important data. So make sure that you take a quick peek. You can see that looks good. If you do want to edit and remove some stuff, you hit that edit button there. And you can do this if you'd like. You don't necessarily have to do this. We can do this at the lab, but if you do that and hit the delete, it'll delete all that unnecessary data that we don't need. But be careful you're not cutting out the data that we do need. It usually highlights in maroon what we're going to cut out. You can see there. Just gives us a nice clean scan. We can clean the rest of that up at the lab. So confirm, I like what that looks like. I'm gonna go to finish. Take a look at the denture, like what I see. You go to pre-design. You have the two scans, the upper and lower denture. You can go to export. If you want to take a look at everything one more time before you send it, you can use these to help look at it. See how it's getting rid of the lower denture. If you want to take a look at it one more time before you send it to the lab, go to export. So after you finish the order, you'll see this drop-down menu to send it to Row Dental Laboratory. You'll select Row, and then you'll just send it, and you're done.